about to do a video. Gosh, why do I have neighbors? What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. It is officially 2022. Wait, there we go. 2022, there we go. Do it. If y'all had any noise in the back, TV, any grass cutters, banging noise, ignore all of it. That's my neighbors, and then that's my mother loud TV. Ignore all of it. So, welcome back to my channel, guys. I feel vlogmas. Yes, I know. I don't want to hear nothing about that. Anyways, that's a pass. It is officially 2022, and oh god. Before we get into this video, I need to talk to you guys because this basically is kind of like a talking video and painting, but you get the concept. If you see anything on my forehead, just ignore that. I really don't know how that got there. I think it was my friend, but it's whatever. So throughout this year, I'm gonna be posting Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. That's the days I'm gonna be dropping. I have planned to drop every day of the week, but I know I couldn't do that because Vlogmas is a complete perfect example that I cannot post every day of the month. So I'm just gonna be posting 3 days throughout the week, and that's the days y'all will see videos from me. But specifically 1 week throughout every month is gonna be prank videos alone, like throughout those 3 days that I scheduled. So that's basically what I plan to do this year for my channel, and hopefully you guys are okay with that. I'm comfortable with that because I'm comfortable with it. I'm gonna do something that I'm comfortable with and something I know I can do. So today is Saturday, of course, January 1st, and today I'm gonna be doing chickens. Today I'm gonna be doing painting with AJ, painting with me, and I'm gonna be talking with you guys like about different topics. I posted stuff on my social medias that will be on the screen and in the description, and I asked you guys to give me topics. Y'all, some of y'all give me some topics that I'm gonna be talking about while painting, and this is what I am going to be painting. I'm gonna be trying to paint this. If y'all know, I showed some of my paintings, like it was only two, but y'all saw what I did before. So I'm gonna be doing that while painting, and I'm gonna be painting that and then talking with you. You'll get the concept. Amelia, shut up. Okay, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to turn on post notifications for when I upload our next video. Follow my social medias, as I said, on the screen and in the description.
And no, that's going to hat back there.
It's only January 1st. Okay, it's going to come out a day later. You know what? Never mind. So first, I'm going to sketch the, I've never drawn, like, anything with animals before. Have I? No. I'm going to sketch this, not on the canvas, on like a piece of paper to see how I do. I'm going to sketch the elephant. Should I sketch the tree? I'm going to sketch the tree and see. So I'm going to do the sketching and then I'm going to get back to you guys. Hold on.
For war, you take one of mine, we take five of yours, and we coming knocking at your door, kicking it down, say you to the Lord. God does he control it? Picture me.
Okay, so I sketched it. No other elephants. You see, don't mind these. Heck, look like they're about to bust off split, but it's okay. It's okay. This is a sketch, you know. It might look worse on the canvas, but it's okay. You know, you only live once, right? Amelia, what does a sketch have? Alright guys, let's get into this. Well, we already entered. I think it's strongly telling me I should sketch. Ooh, my stomach. Ooh, I'm doing this video on an empty stomach. It's almost 4 o'clock, but it's okay. Something telling me strongly I should sketch the tree, but I'm gonna ignore that thing that's telling me strongly to sketch the tree. Alright, so I'm not gonna paint yet. I'm gonna show something I need y'all to do. Alright? I'm gonna show something I need y'all to do. So when y'all, like, you know, watching my channel, I want y'all to click on the channel. Well, not literally click on the channel, because when you're watching this video, you can see the button right underneath the video. So I'm gonna need y'all, you see this red perfect looking button that says the word subscribe. I need y'all to click that. Okay? That's not done. That's the first step. Once y'all click that, right? You see this little bell here? This little ding 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 bell right here? I'm gonna need y'all to click that too. Wait, if it says this, don't press none, don't press personalize. I need you to press all. And then once you do that, I will love you forever. I already love you. But you know, it's just gonna make it way 10 times better. Mwah. Hasta la vista. I don't know what that means. I think that means bye. Okay, let's paint. So I'm gonna put the paint. I should have done this already, but I'm gonna put the paint on this paper. And I'm gonna put this laptop on mute. That's a desktop, but it's okay. So I'm gonna put the paint that I need on the this paper. And I think I need to this isn't even open. Okay. I need, when I'm doing the background, like the sunset, basically, I don't know. I think I need to let that dry first so I can paint over. Oh, that's the thing. So I can paint the tree and the elephants and the grass over. I'm trying not to do this hard because when you do this, that's the same reason why Saint. Is that my pants? Give me a minute. Oh, that sunset hitting in my belly. Alright, tip one, right, when it comes to painting. Remember, always wear clothes that you don't really care about. Because these pants are going to turn into my paint pants, alright? So always wear clothes. That's a lot of paint for the red. That's a lot of paint. Always wear clothes that you don't really care about. Step two, make sure you have paper towels on deck. Because those come in serious handy. If you want, you can even add gloves. But me, I'm broke. I don't have no gloves in my... Gloves. Great. I don't have no gloves in my house right now. So, that's just gonna... Yeah, these nails ain't even cheap. Okay. We're gonna just work with what we have. I'm not even into the topics yet. But it's okay. We're gonna put the paint... I'm gonna put the paint on the... Oh, I thought this one wasn't open. Onto the plate. That's red, that's orange, yellow, and black. I may need a good amount of black, I don't know. The paint farted. Amelia is 2022. Alright, so we have our paint. I might need more, I'm not sure yet. But, that's our paint. Alright. So, I'm going to start the backdrop and the backdrop. Is it really considered a backdrop though? Because I feel like you'll use backdrop in like taking. Oh, God. I feel like you use backdrop in like taking pictures with like a camera. So, like the backdrop that's behind the person. Like the. Yeah, I got my point. Alright. What's my brushes? So, we got my brushes and then we got some water to rinse the paint out of the brush when I'm done using the brush. Alright. So the first topic that someone gave me was New Year's resolution. She said revolution, but I think she meant resolution. You asking me in the back? It's okay. So I don't really have a lot for my New Year's resolution, to be honest. I feel like the one main thing that I really want to get done this year is my relationship with God, because I used to care about it, like I still do, but it's just like I took it like a lot more seriously in 2020 than last year. 2020. If y'all had strong winds in the back, it is very windy. It was rainy, windy from since all yesterday. So I took it more seriously in like 2022 than. Not 2022 ain't even start yet. I took it more seriously in 2020 than 2021. 2021 is like when the year started, is like I started to drift away, and then as the year continued, it just became worse and worse and worse. And it's like I just put him behind everything else when I shouldn't, because he should be the number one person priority in my life when it comes to anything else. Because I mean, he's the one in control of my life, he's the one taking care of me. Well, not literally, but I should understand what I mean. So yeah, that's one main thing that I want to do for this year. And I don't even have paint on the canvas yet. Okay. Anything else I really want this year? Because I feel that's my number one. And I think number two would be growing my channel more. Like, taking it more seriously, grinding more hard on it. Like, I kind of want y'all to see me, but at the same time, I need to paint. So I'm going to just hold it and talk to y'all. So, yeah, I feel like I need to take the channel more seriously, and that's another thing that I need to do this year, is This looks like orange. That's not supposed to look like that. I didn't. Okay, I'm gonna add more of the red to this. It's gonna look weird. I just know it. It's gonna look weird because it's like two different colors, but it's supposed to be the same color, but it's like, I mean, it is from two different brands. Don't do what I do, okay? Just don't do it. What does this say? Primary red cadmium. It says red, but alright. So yeah, as I was saying, I want to take the channel more seriously, and I want to post more content. I want to just, like, the schedule I said with, like, 3 days a week, I want to take that seriously. Like, I actually want to do that and focus on that. Like, not say, like, oh, I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. Like I said with Vlogmas, I said I was going to take Vlogmas seriously, which I didn't. I only uploaded three videos for Vlogmas, and Vlogmas has 25 days. Well, the Vlogmas, not the month. So Vlogmas has 25 days. So I failed that tremendously when I should have took it more seriously. But hey, we all make mistakes, don't we? You learn to live. You live to learn. Make mistakes. Grow. Other stuff. Yeah. Anything else? I'm trying to think of anything else. Because I said I was going to put this on paper, but I didn't. Or like my notes, but I didn't. I'm trying to think of anything else that I have. I do want to find true happiness. Yeah, I do want to find true happiness, find my true self. I want to put myself first, you know. Because I felt like I used to be putting other people before myself and actually before taking care of myself, and I need to do that. So I feel like putting myself in front and making myself my priority, like, to find myself truly and better myself, that's another thing that I want to do this year. Last year was just a ride, hell for me. Last year is like I felt like it was just a challenge back to back, having to dig myself out of this hole, left, right, front, back and center. Every month was just something new. I felt like last year was truly the most difficult year I ever lived. Not that I have, hopefully I have more years to live, but you got the point. Last year was just different. I don't know why. So yeah, finding true happiness, bettering myself for me, building my relationship with God fully. What was the other thing? The channel. Anything else? Damn, this water already turned color. I think that's it. Ooh. Wet like ocean. No, the paper is... You know what? Never. Alright, I'm gonna finish this backdrop. Well, I'm gonna go halfway and I'm gonna come back. Okay. Alright, so I finished the orange. I should have done more red, like put red at least up to here. Like up to there, But I'm gonna do the yellow now. So another topic someone gave me. Did I really finish the resolutions? I don't really have a lot stuff to focus on. Oh, I do, guys, look at this. That's what I was saying, like, it was, you know what, never mind. So, I do want to, you know what, I'm not gonna say this. I'm not. I got peanut butter. Okay, it's gone now. Alright. Clorox wipes will do the trick. All right, next topic I got was school. who has been? Hold on. I'll be back. I need to change out this water. That's why I keep going. Yeah, baby. You gotta keep going. Oh. I am back, Benito. I have no idea what that means, but I'm just saying stuff at this point. Alright, we need to do the yellow. Okay, so back to what I was saying. School. I'm not gonna lie. School before this whole pandemic in 2019, it was, I'm not gonna lie, I miss it. I miss normal school where you could just go out to school. You know, don't have to worry about no pandemic. Don't have to worry about a mask. It's like, I miss that. It's nor. I can't get the word out. I'm trying to make it sound smart, like normal, but with like a twist on it. I'm trying to make myself sound smart, but it's not working out. Okay, so I miss that normalness. That's kind of what I'm trying to say, but not really. So yeah, I miss it. Cause it's like, life was so simple. You know, but it's like this pandemic is like so much has changed. I don't think life will ever be the same again. It's been a whole a legit. It's 2 years, right? Yeah, it's basically almost 3 years since this whole pandemic had been here. And it's crazy because when 2020 had started, to be honest, we never heard nothing about the pandemic. I remember one time I was in my room, like, late, like, it was probably, like, around 11 or something. And then I was scrolling on my phone, and then I came across something that said something about the corona. This was probably in, like, January, like, late January, early February, or, like, middle of January, something like that. And I came across something about the pandemic, and I think it was saying something about pandemic coming from, it didn't say the pandemic, but it was saying something from the virus coming from, like, China or something like that. I was like, okay. Hopefully that heck don't make it for here. That's legit what I said in my head. Then boom, February hits. Like late February. Because I remember that's when they closed down school. It was late February. And then they didn't say nothing. But it's like, there was like, you know, they finna give us stuff. Like to finish, like work to finish off the school year. And stuff like that. So in my head, I remember when that happened. I'm like, okay. This should be gone by the end of this year. That's the end of 2020. I was like, okay. You know, probably by when I start. Because I was in 7th grade when this happened. I'm legit in 9th right now. I was like, okay. By the time I hit 8th grade, everything should be back to normal. You know? Back to school. Yeah. Bam. 8th grade hit. Nothing changed. The only thing that changed was the pandemic grew. I'm not gonna lie. It grew bigger than I thought. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it helped me open my eyes up to certain stuff, but at the same time, it took away some stuff from me. So it's like, you win some, you lose some, you change. It was a whole lot. Come on. Not gonna lie, when it started, it was kind of cool because it's like, you know, we could have been home, and it's like, it wasn't like we was doing online. It's like they gave us like packets and like online work, but it's like we didn't have no teachers. We just have to make sure we finish the work and turn it in. That's how the end of my 7th grade was. So I was cool with it because it's like we could have done it anytime. Well, no, the stuff online it was due like at a certain time, so those we couldn't. But the packets we could have done the packets anytime. So I was like, okay, this should be fun, but you know. 8th grade is going to be better because 8th grade was my last year in middle school. So I'm like, alright, this is cool. 8th grade hits. No, I'm not going to lie. At the start of 8th grade, like before it was start, like I think it was like August, our governor said that he was going to open it back up. He said that, you know, we'll be back in school by time. Because I remember, wait, did he say that? Was that 8th grade or 9th grade? I don't even remember, but I felt like 8th grade, it was like we were supposed to go back, but we didn't. And that was the same with 9th grade. It was always some situation happened that we just didn't go back. So 8th grade, I did my whole 8th grade year online. That whole year was just online. Nothing in person. Kind of wish I saw my teachers in person though, because I had some good teachers for 8th grade. So, bomb 8th grade finish, 9th grade. In my opinion, I feel like I thought 9th grade would have been easier. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's easy. Why am I mixing up my word? I'm trying to concentrate and talk at the same time, and it's making me mess up my words. Okay, we finished it. Ooh, this actually looks good. It's gotta dry now, though. I'm gonna put the fan on it so it can dry. Put that brush in the water. Alright, so some days I had my moments where I felt like 9th grade was easier than like middle school. I don't know why, probably it's just because I'm smart, but. Alright, let me stop. Okay, so some days I felt like 9th grade was easier, but then it had some days that 9th grade took a toll on me. Where it's like, I would get up and it's like, I would not feel like doing anything. And it came to the point where it was like, I would wake up legit a minute before class and then jump on the computer. And I didn't like that because it's like, I didn't have no time to get myself ready to go in front of the computer. You get my point? So it's like, because sometimes, I'm not gonna lie, when I was in middle school, I never expected my high school to be like this, especially the start of it. Like, I expected to be in person with my teachers, you know, my classmates, getting to know my high school or whatever, but it just wasn't like that. It just wasn't. And I'm halfway through 9th grade, and it's like, it went by like this. 2020 came, 2020 gone. Because, I mean, you have to say 2020 when you're saying 2021, so kind of, okay, so I meant to say 2021 came, went like that. And it's crazy because it's like so much stuff happened in 2021 and so much people didn't make it. And it's like sometimes instead of looking at all the bad things that happened in 2021, you can take the good out of it. Like, okay, this, you actually made it to 2022 because so many people didn't. I lost my grandfather in 2020. I was finished in 2021, but I lost him in 2020 and that still took a toll on me. When Christmas came last month, like when it, because I was up at, I was up like when it hit 12:01 for Christmas, and I legit cried because it's like at that point I realized he really was gone. And it's like, because every Christmas when he was here, it would be good. Like, we would go by my grandmother, all my family would go by my grandmother, we would spend time, and like he was there, and you know, he like, just him being there, it just felt good. But for Christmas, like 2020, it was like, it was okay because he died in September, October. I think he died late, early September. Yeah, he died in September, September 10th. And then Christmas was 3 months after that. So it's like, it was the wound was still kind of fresh. But it's like when 2021 hit, like Christmas hit, it was like, okay, it truly hit me. It still hit me, but it's like that point, like I truly felt like he really hit. So that part really hit me hard. Wait, what was I talking about? Oh my god. I like, I was supposed to talk about school, but I head into that. But it was basically revolving around how school and just... because school was one of the main things that changed me. Because I wasn't how I was when the... if you see the crop? Can y'all see that? Bro. But yeah, the pandemic is like... the pandemic and school was just... school is school. I mean, gotta do what you gotta do. I'm not mad at it, but at the same time, because it's like some days, I'm not gonna lie, I truly feel like school was one thing that kept me going. Because when like some long breaks would come, I would like be like, okay, when's school gonna open back up? Because school was one of the only things like that was, I was really doing, that was productive, and that really kept me going. So when school wasn't going, it was like, school, where you at? But it's like some days I would feel like, bro, I don't want to go to school, I'm not ready for this. It was kind of like an on and off type thing with school. But I'm still on Christmas break right now. We go back January 10th. I say 10th like a Spanish person. Okay, I'm sorry. So they said we're supposed to go back January 10th. They say that we might go in person, but I truly do not think that's true, because out of nowhere the pandemic, the COVID cases just started to rise, and I really find that weird how out of nowhere it just starts going up like that. Like, some people don't find it weird, but to me that's extremely weird, because out of nowhere, like really out of nowhere, that heck just starts to rise. Why? I know. So I'm gonna let this dry. I'm gonna probably let it dry for like 10 minutes, and then I'm gonna come back because I got one more topic to talk about, and I will try to talk about that within the tree and the elephant. So I will let this dry, and I'll be back with you guys probably in like 10 to 15 minutes. With you, it would be like a split second. That wasn't even 10 minutes, bro. I'm so serious. This like is completely dry. That wasn't even 10 minutes. That was probably like a minute and a half. But yeah. So I kind of need to focus for this part. I kind of need to focus for this part because it's black. And it's like the really, it's like the really important part of the paint. What should I do? Well, I should do the... You know what I just thought? Why did I paint all the way to the bottom? Because I need to put like, why did I do this? I need to put like a ground type where the elephant walks on and like the trees on. Oh my god. And if I put black completely over it, it's gonna look weird. Well, time to improvise. I'm gonna just put grasses, the tree, and the elephant on the bottom. I'm not stressing myself right now. Okay, so my last topic is... I might use that for the grass. Should I? I'm looking to see if it would make any better if I want to test it, but at the same time, I don't want to mess it up. Let me see. Oh, my black started to get hard. Okay, it can still work. It can still work. Alright. So, my last topic I got was relationships. I have so many points on relationships. It's funny. Let me finish the bottom part and I'll get back on. Camera just shut off. Not camera, my phone camera just shut off. I think I'm max on storage, but it's okay. As I was saying, once you feel like you have that maturity mindset to handle a relationship, it shouldn't be a problem. That's where the tree was supposed to go. Wait. Oh, I'm so sorry. Alright, once you feel like you, okay. I feel like I'm mature enough. I can handle a relationship. I got this. Be my guest. Go right ahead. But once you're in that relationship with someone, and say, for example, you and your partner get into issues, don't be the person to be like, okay, I'm not going to do this with you. Ignore it. Don't do that. I feel like give them time to cool off. Ignore them if you... I just said don't ignore them. But instead of having an argument, I mean that you're mixing up your words. As I was saying, instead of making an argument with your partner, take some time to yourself. Once you feel like you cooled off, or both of y'all cooled off, come back, talk, communicate, say what you felt, let your other partner talk, how you guys felt about the situation, or whatever went down, and just let them know how you felt. Don't step away from the situation. Don't say, you know what, I can't do this with you, break up, this and that. Nope, it takes effort and time into a relationship with your partner. I'm just trying to stay focused on the stream right now. This one isn't working that good. Bro, it doesn't want to come out. Okay, this is my mother's new rug. I'm not trying to get paint on it. I'm going to finish this tree and I'm gonna get back. Okay. Oh, my stomach hurts, bro. I haven't eaten all day. So I finished the bottom part. So if you kind of see, instead of like the picture, like it was flat, kind of did like a curve, like hills type vibe. So I'm about to do the grass. All right, so my views on relationship. I feel like at my specific age, 14, 15, I don't think no one should be in a relationship from 12. 12? Well, to be honest, it's according to your mindset. Like, once you feel like... Once you feel like you're mature enough, like you have that mature mindset and you feel like, okay, you can handle a relationship, you can handle having a partner, you can handle the problems that comes with the relationship, you can handle the effort that needs to be in a relationship. Because a relationship isn't just one person, it's two people. That's the point why it's called. Hello. This tree ain't perfect like the picture, but it's something, alright? Me ain't professional. And plus, I was running low on black. Me even do the elephant yet with the grass. But we will make it work. It is something. It's something. I guess. Oh, wait. What was I last saying? Oh, okay. So, we're going to do the grass now. I think I can talk while doing the grass. Something that people forget that's really big in relationship is communication. You cannot have a relationship without communication. That's like having a car with no gas. That's a perfect example. I am so proud of that. Yeah, that's like having a car with no gas. Once you're in a relationship, you need to know to communicate with your partner. You need, when something feeling asked to you, let them know. When you feeling a type of, these grass both look like ass. Once something is feeling off to you in a relationship, let your partner know. Once you feel in a type of way, let your partner know. If your partner did something to upset you, let your partner know. Y'all cannot grow if y'all do not communicate. It's just no point in it. Trying to see where I'll put the elephant. I think I'll put it like in here. So yeah, communication is key. Having a positive mindset for a relationship is key. And I feel like you cannot have a relationship with two broken tools. That's like repairing a car with no engine. Alright, coming in clutch with these comparisons. Alright, so yeah. And I forgot what I was talking about again. Damn. Oh yeah, you cannot have a relationship with two broken souls. One of y'all has to know, at least be happy. Sheesh. It's not gonna work. Two broken people together in a relationship, that's not gonna work. I mean, it can if, you know, somebody get their act together and most of y'all just, you know, be like, okay, look, babe, we need to do this. We need to get our lives together. We need to sort this out, this and that. Then, you know, yeah, be good. Other stuff. Okay, another thing. If you're my age and you're not ready for a relationship, do not make someone force you into a relationship. If you feel like, okay, look, hey, I'm 14, I don't think I have time for a relationship, I have school to focus on, I have goals to chase, I have this and this and this. Do not let someone force you into a relationship if you know you're not ready for it. Matter of fact, that goes for all ages. If you're not ready for it, don't let someone force you into it. Because Oh, talk about forcing. If you're in a relationship with someone and they bust the three words, those three words, if they bust out to you and you don't feel it the same way, do not say it back. Because you're hurting yourself and you're hurting that person. Do not say it back. Because it's like you're lying, and that's not good. So if you know you're not ready or you do not feel a type of way, do not say back. let them know straight up, hey, look, I care about you, but I don't think I'm ready for that big step yet. Like, whoop, whoop, bop, 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 this and that. Yeah. Anything else I have about relationships to say? It's like y'all ever talking and it's so much you want to say, but you just don't know how to put it. That's the type of person I am. It's like so much I could say, but I just don't know how to put it into words. And I really don't want to make this video long, and I feel like this video is already over 20 minutes. So I'm just going to finish this elephant. I told y'all this grass is going to look like ass, all right? I'm going to finish the elephant, and I'm going to get back with y'all. I don't know why my sketch look better than the actual height. Hold on. I didn't get to add the mama elephant because I kind of made it like in a small space, and I know the mama elephant wasn't gonna fit there, so I kind of just made the baby one. I don't know why this look like a person crawling. But this is the finished product. It's not that good. Okay, where are you going? Yeah. See that look? I don't think the mama elephant would have fit in that small space, so I kind of just made it the baby one. Just pretend there's a mama elephant right there. But yeah, this is the finished product. If y'all want me to make this a series, painting, like painting and talking with AJ, let me know in the comments down below. Let me know what up. If y'all want me to make this series, but I wouldn't mind actually. This felt good. This felt what's the word? I can't find the word. Okay, so make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to turn on post notifications for when I drop the next video Monday. And don't forget to follow me on all my social medias. That will be on the screen and in the description. I love you guys so much. See you guys in the next video.